Princeton game is always, you know, our last game. We didn't win, but it's kind of a disappointing season. And so fast forward 2 weeks, you know, coach gives us like a week and a half off, and that's kind of where things got crazy. So, and I was feeling like really awful. So I like called student health at 8 a.m. like as soon as it opened, and told them that like I was really sick and like I couldn't walk there. So they sent like a van over to come and pick me up. At this point, like I couldn't move my arm because it was like an abscess or something there. And basically they were like, yeah, you can't be here. Like you have to go to the hospital. So they called an ambulance, and the ambulance came and got me and took me to the hospital. And I went right to the ER. And at that point, like I was like very in and out of sleep. Like don't really remember much. And I remember them telling me that my parents need to come up. So I was thinking like, wow, like this might be serious. They kept telling me that it was a virus. And so they were just gonna hold me over in, I guess, the overnight waiting room to see how I'll progress or whether anything would change. And apparently my whole body like turned bright red, like really red. And that's when they knew that something was wrong. They ended up having to put me on a respirator for like 6 days. In order to do that, they had to medically, you know, induce a coma. They found out that there was a staph infection, but there was a very rare strain of staph called, it's like the toxic shock strain of staph infection. And typically, people don't survive that. Imagine being a parent in that situation. That's something that every parent fears. And at one point, my parents actually called like my grandparents and my brothers, and like my whole immediate family didn't know like what would happen. So they wanted everyone to be there just in case like that was my last breath. Like when I woke up, I started feeling better, and so they moved me to a different room. And at this point, like I still just had been in a hospital bed for about a week and a half and hadn't moved from the bed. My main goal was to like get up and walk. And so I had like physical therapists come and work with me. The first day, like I it took so much out of me to just like sit up and like put my legs over the side of the bed. Probably about 4 or 5 days later, I was able to like get up and walk to the bathroom. It's like a big feat. And I remember just feeling so proud of myself. After I first got moved to the room, my whole team came. And when you're in a hospital room and you have no idea when you're getting out, and it's really those people that come to visit you that helps the time go by. Because all the other time you're talking to doctors or checking up on you, and you're staring at the wall or the TV. There's no like real personal interaction. My teammates have been very supportive even after that. Like I said, it's taken me a while to get back to on the court. Sat out all last year because I had some reoccurring, you know, issues that kept me off the court. But my teammates just kept checking up on me and seeing how I was, you know, emotionally, mentally, and I just can't thank them enough. Like I haven't played a game in over a year, almost 2 years, and just very nervous and just blessed. I wasn't supposed to survive that infection, you know, and I survived. And you know, I wasn't supposed to have all the function that I have now, you know, but I have it, and wasn't supposed to be able to get back in shape, like to play, but I've been able to do that. And I just feel very blessed. I can say that before I got sick, I took for granted like personal interaction, like I mentioned earlier. But now I just try to live in the moment and try to do everything that I can, like to the best of my ability. So if, you know, I'm having lunch with someone, I am 100% there. you know, instead of, you know, texting someone or, you know, looking at Facebook, I'm 100% there, because you never know what might happen. Put a lot of things in perspective, like when you almost have your life taken away from you, you realize what's important to you, like what's not important. Tomorrow's not promised, and, you know, make the most of every second that you have, you know, breathing on this earth. Like you never know what'll happen and when it'll be taken away from you, so. My name is Jamal Lewis, and I am Penn.